diciamo oggi in ogni anno e mezzo un pendere a dare che sono
sposato. Oh yes. Oh yes.
Because celebration praise are actually things that are done by people with an understanding in touch school or always not in work.
Oh yes.
So why should we not celebrate if the victory is already ours?
Exactly.
What the Bible says, you shall go through the fire, go through the water, but I mean you are going through. No, you missed it. You are already going what?
Through.
That doesn't mean you will die in the water.
Oh, yes.
That doesn't mean you will die in the fire.
Oh, yes.
Somebody declared, say, I'm going through.
I'm going through.
It means your end is already defined.
Amen.
I'm not going to marry anymore.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh yes.
I tell yourself by name. Tell yourself by name, man. You are just going through. You are just going through.
Tradition. You are just going through
the fire. You are just going through the rivers.
You are just going through the fire. You are just going through the rivers. Your past papa.
Alpha, actually the original rendering doesn't have end. is Alpha Omega. And people think Alpha Omega means from the beginning to what? No, that's wrong. It's actually a God who goes to the end and sort out everything. Then comes back to the beginning. So when whatever you are now walking in, God has already been there. So wait, let me show you this. Do you know what the Bible means when it says God created the world in 6 days and on the seventh day he rested? Do you know what it means? Whatever will happen has happened in the 6 days. Now, let me try again. Can I tell you my workers sick and yika in 7 days?
Oh yes, sir.
The reason why he is now resting is because he has finished working. He's not going to wake up and work tomorrow because you need rent. No, he has already gone there and created your rent and finished whether it's a house or That's why Mama was talking about what? Rest. We're in the Sabbath. You know, our problem with Adventists is they think we deny the existence of Sabbath. The only difference is we don't believe in that shallow Sabbath of Saturday. No, Bible says, enter your rest. You enter your rest and you live in your rest. So we are actually in our Sabbath today. Not because it's a Sunday. Our argument is not which day is the Sabbath day. Or which day is the Sabbath. No, our argument is we are in our Sabbath. We are in a day. And they want us to believe in a chronological day. We are in the spiritual day of the Lord. We are in the Sabbath. We are in our rest. The Bible says, "Can a man rest himself from his labor?" But in the end of the Bible, they will take what we live and what kingdom Sabbath is.
Victorious Sabbath.
Are you believing this? I feel like showing you this thing. Can I show you this thing? See now. When mom said rest, I heard it. But I don't think you heard it. Somebody said, "I am in my rest." Go to the second. Let's try to just remove the veil on this thing. Help Hebrews chapter number 4.
Let us therefore fear.
Are you on episode number 4?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure you are on episode number 4?
Yes, sir.
Because I want you to see certain things on your own. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
I'm waiting for answers. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Alright, let's go. Verse 1.
Let us therefore fear, lest the promise being left us of entering into his rest.
So, what was left us as a promise?
Of entering into
the promise of entering into God's rest.
Amen.
It's called his rest, God's rest.
Any of you should seem to come short of it. For unto us was the gospel preached, as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. For we which have believed do enter into rest.
So, what happens when you believe?
Enter into rest.
The word the rest there is the word Sabbath.
Amen.
So, you enter into rest, not Sabbath.
Amen.
I don't know if you're getting this. So, that Sabbath was symbolic. It was a shadow of the things that Jesus is and brought to us.
Amen.
Are you sure you're getting it?
For we which have believed to enter into rest, as he said, as I have sworn in my wrath, if they shall enter into my rest, although the works were finished from the foundation of the world.
The works were finished from the foundation of the world.
Amen. For he spake in a certain place of the seventh day.
Now, in a certain place, he spoke of the what?
The seventh day. On this wise. And God did rest the seventh day from all his works. And in this place again, if they shall enter into my rest, see, therefore, it remaineth that some must enter daily, and they to whom it was first preached entered not in, because
now, those who think kept the Sabbath never entered. Amen. Because they were following carnal rules.
Amen.
Yet it was a prophetic message about a certain kind of rest.
Amen.
So in that place, he spoke in images and times, and he spoke about the Saturday. But here again, he's speaking about that day. Let's go.
Again, he limited a certain day.
Again,
he limited a certain day.
Again,
he limited a certain day.
A certain day. Someone saying a certain day.
A certain day.
Uh-huh.
Saying David, today, after so long a time, as it is said, today if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts. For if Jesus had given them rest, then would he not afterward have spoken of another day?
So, if he had given them rest on Saturday, he was never going to speak again over another one.
Another day.
Uh-huh.
Therefore, remaineth therefore a rest to the people of God.
So, therefore, remaineth the one?
A rest
for the people of God.
For he that is entered into his rest, he also has ceased from his own works, as God did from his.
Are you hearing this?
Yes, Lord.
So, there is a day that God ceased to work. But if you enter into your rest, you cease working. Why? Because it's no longer you who is supposed to work, but faith in what was working.
Amen.
That's why we are talking about victory being something that we have already attained by being in Christ.
Amen.
That's why we are talking about fighting from a what? Place of victory, not for victory. Why? Because he has already won the victory. So if you enter into your rest, you cease to work.
Oh, yes.
And the works that are expected from you after entering into rest are just that works of faith.
Oh, yes.
Have I helped someone?
Yes.
Say, oh God.
Oh God.
I thank you.
I thank you.
For the word.
For the word.
That I believed.
That I believed.
And I entered.
And I entered.
Into my rest.
Into my
just
rest.
Thank him for 1 minute. 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 Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Ghost. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
So, we are moving with this season of victory teaching.
Amen.
And those who are following, ask them, are you following?
Are you following?
The teaching.
The teaching.
Those who are following, we are dealing with keys to consistent victory. Right?
Oh, yes.
And last Sunday, we dealt with standing on the platform of the covenant. Rather, standing on the platform of faith, which is called the covenant. The platform is of faith. But the point was the covenant. And we used David as an example. And we are still on David, right?
Yes.
1 Samuel chapter number 17, verse 45 today. And we want to take another principle from that story. We want to take our problem. Our problem. Somebody say our problem.
Our problem.
You know, when I tell you you have a problem, accept it so that you will solve it.
Amen.
Right? Say my problem.
My problem.
My problem.
My problem.
Is wanting.
Is wanting.
The result of David.
The result of David.
But denying.
But denying.
The principles of David.
The principles of David.
What do I mean by that? Don't just pray saying, oh God, you did it for David. And you're not a respecter of personalities. You can also do it for me. It's true. Whatever he once did, He can do it then. Right? But you must be very careful to check why God did it for David. I said something right there.
Yes.
You did it for Abraham, you did it for David, you did it. But if you will look at those people, they then became portraits of certain principles. Abraham is called our father of
faith.
So if you want Abraham's results, you must have the faith of Abraham.
Oh, yes.
Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Jacob became a portrait of encounter or seeking God. These are they who seek ye, O God of Jacob. It actually says, these are them who seek you, O Jacob. It actually removed God and replaced God with Jacob. Why? Because Jacob sought God until he got the blessing.
Yes.
He fought with God in an encounter after sending everything across the river Jordan. And he sought God until he had an encounter that changed not just his name, but even the trajectory of his family's life.
Oh, yes.
He became the father of many nations after an encounter.
Oh, yes.
So don't just say, you did it for Abraham, you did it for Jacob, you did it for David. The lifestyle of those people.
Amen.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes. Oh, yes.
Are you hearing that?
Amen.
So can we check David's lifestyle? Can we check? Can we check? Are you there?
Yes, yes.
So, last week we checked and we discovered that the difference between David and his brothers who were running away for 40 days and 40 nights, which is equal to a generation, right?
Yes, sir.
You're coming from families where generations have been chased by devils,
yes,
and running away from devils. You go to the villages, there are houses that are falling down, and you ask, those people are saying what? Whatever wrong? Yes, sir. The royalties again. Never in the UK, I don't know what you did that to one. You want to tease the Marai? Kala para dia kadosh adena makapaya basubu brada. So, David's brothers were running away simply because they missed a key principle called the covenant. Someone say the covenant.
The covenant.
If you hear David just saying something like, who is this uncircumcised? He is already mentioning that this one is not in covenant.
Oh, yes.
So the reason why he is going down is because I am in covenant.
Amen.
That was last week. If you missed it, please check it out. Today, I want to move to something. 45.
Then say David to the Philistine.
Wait. Already, we are in. Then
say David.
Then
say David.
Then
say David.
Then
say David.
Okay, put your name. Then
say Marshall.
Then
say Marshall.
Then
say Marshall.
Uh-huh.
To the Philistine.
To
the Philistine.
To
the Philistine.
No, no, no. To
poverty.
Yeah. To
sickness.
To whatever Goliath you are facing. You are not going to manifest the victory unless you learn how to speak right. Then say it. So there is already a lesson to start. What type of words comes out of a victor?
Amen.
Let's go.
Thou comest to me with a sword, and with a spear, and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defied. This day will the Lord deliver thee into my hand, and I will smite thee, and take thine head from thee, and I will give the carcasses of the host of the Philistines this day unto the fowls of the air, and to the wild beasts of the earth, and all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel. And all this assembly shall know that the Lord serveth not sword and spear, for the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you into our hands.
Now, I want you to just listen to the words of a victor.
Amen.
He is facing a giant.
Amen.
I don't know what you are facing.
Amen.
But what are you seeing when you are looking at your problem?
Amen.
Are you amplifying it? Are you giving it power? Are you I don't know what you are doing to that enemy, but this is a man speaking to his problem.
Amen.
This is a man speaking to his enemy.
Amen.
And he's not looking at his size, because his words are governed by an understanding that the victory has already been won.
Amen.
I am not the one fighting. So if it is God fighting, what language should come out of my mouth? What result should I confess?
Amen.
What declaration should I make regarding my situation?
Yes.
I don't know if you're getting this.
Yes, yes.
Did you know? Pay attention. Are you here?
Yes, perfect.
Did you know that by your words, just opening your mouth to speak, you are either speaking yourself into victory or you are speaking yourself into defeat?
Oh, yes.
Amen. Let me try again. I said, did you know that the moment you open your mouth to speak, in the subject of victory, it's either you are speaking yourself into a victory or you are speaking yourself into
defeat.
Ask your neighbor, what are you saying?
What are you saying?
What will you
do? What will you do?
Are you speaking yourself into victory or you are speaking yourself into defeat? It doesn't matter what you're going through. What determines whether victory or defeat is not the size of your enemy.
Amen.
It's the kind of your words.
Amen.
Let me teach. Can I teach you? Luke chapter number 17, verse 6. Luke chapter number 17, verse 6. Luke chapter number 17, verse number 6.
And the Lord said, if ye had faith as a grain of mustard seed, ye might say unto this sycamine tree.
If you have what?
Faith as a grain of mustard seed.
Wait. If you have what?
Faith.
As
a grain of mustard seed.
Mustard what?
Seed.
Faith. Seed. Let's go.
You might say unto this.
You might.
Say.
Are you joining the dots?
Yes, prophet.
Number one word, faith.
Faith.
Number two word,
say.
See. Number three,
say.
So you cannot claim to have faith if you don't have seed. And you cannot claim to have faith and seed, which gives faith, if you are not saying. Now let's go.
You might say unto this sycamine tree, be thou plucked up by the root, and be thou planted in the sea, and it should obey you.
And it
should obey you.
Should. As long as it is faith, which you got from the correct seed, you must say. And whatever you are speaking to should obey you.
Yes.
So if anything happens which is not what we have had then, there is something that is wrong with the equation.
Amen.
Saying that what you are calling faith is not faith.
Oh, yes.
Saying that what you are calling sin is wrong sin.
Amen.
And it's saying that you have faith as a result of correct sin, but you are not speaking.
Amen.
Am I talking to somebody?
Oh, yes, prophet.
Are you sure you are here? 1 John chapter 5 verse 4. Remember our key scriptures. For whatsoever is borrowed, overcome it. The world. And this is the victory. This is the one.
Victory.
That overcometh the world. Even our
faith.
Even our
faith.
Even our faith.
Amen.
Whatsoever is born. Somebody say born.
Born.
Of God overcometh the world. And the victory that overcometh the world is our what?
Our
faith. Now, I was looking at this scripture. And I was shaking this scripture. Building precept upon precept. I want to also check 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 23. 1 Peter 1 23. Already check 1 Peter 1 23. I want you to master this thing.
Be born again, not of corruptible seed.
Remember, whatsoever is what? Born of God, overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even
our faith.
Now, it's saying, now, it's dealing now with the person who is born of God. Whatsoever is born of God, right?
Yes.
How is it buried by God? Let's go.
being born again.
So if you are the one born of God, you overcome the world. Because you are born
again. Not of corruptible seed.
Not of corruptible seed. You are not born out of corruptible seed.
But of incorruptible, by the word of God, which liveth and abideth forever.
Now watch.
For
I was checking this scripture, and I wanted to understand what does it really mean. You'll be shocked as I reveal it to you now. This person is born again. And born again means born of God. John chapter number 1 verse 12. Unto them who believed in his name.
Oh yes.
He gave them the what? Power to be called the sons of God.
Oh, yes.
But then it defines those who were not born by the will of men, nor by the will of the blood, nor by the will of the flesh, but by the what? Will of God. Now, watch. The word will then is the same word in John chapter number 1, verse 1.
Oh, yes.
In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was
God.
That word, word there is not logos, it's logan. And logan deals with the thought process, it deals with the will, it deals with the mind of a man.
Oh, yes.
So that's why it is being said to have been there in the beginning with God. And that's why it was said it is God.
Amen. Oh yes.
I get it.
Yes, oh, yes.
And then by that same will he gave birth. Which means his will, which is his seed, is his spirit. So when you are born again, you are born of God. But I know you are not getting it still. You are a child of God. But you are not getting it still. You are a result of God's spirit. Because his word is his seed.
Oh, yes.
The word is seed in there is sperma. Spermatozo. Sperms. So what gave birth to a child of God is God's word, because that is God's will, that is God's seed, that is God's spirit.
Oh yes.
So when it now says you was not born out by, born again by a seed, that is what? Corruptible. I want to take you further now. What does it mean? It means this seed cannot be corrupted to fail.
Amen.
It cannot be spoiled to fail.
Oh yes.
It cannot be caused to fail.
Amen.
So the reason why you are an overcomer, the reason why whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world, is because the instrument, the ingredient that God used to give birth to you does not fail.
Oh yes.
You are a result of a seed that cannot be corrupted to fail.
Amen.
No witch can speak that word to corrupt it in order for it to cause it to fail.
Oh yes.
So the reason why you cannot fail is because the word that God used to give birth to you has got an order of the spirit.
Oh yes.
And according to its order in the spirit, it's programmed to pass.
Amen.
It's programmed to succeed.
Oh, yes.
It's programmed to win every battle.
Amen.
It's programmed to heal every sickness.
Oh, yes.
It's programmed to take you out of any problem.
Amen.
Are we together, Jesus?
Yes, prophet.
So when I stand here and I tell you you are victorious, I know the seed by which you were spared. I know how you came to be as a child of God. I know I have studied the word and I have discovered it cannot fail.
Amen.
It cannot fail.
Amen.
Isaiah 55 verse 11 says, so shall my word be which proceeded out of my mouth. It shall not return back to me void, but it shall what? Accomplish that which I sent it to know what this means.
Your passport.
When God sends a word,
oh yes,
it does not fail in the order of its course. It doesn't have attributes to even be corrupted to fail.
Oh yes.
So as long as it is the word, which is the seed, giving birth to you, number one, and giving faith to you, number two, you are an overcomer.
Amen. Amen.
Okay, my prophet, why is it that I have prayed, I have fasted, I have quoted the word, and I'm not still seeing the desired result? I have used the word of God to pray for my child. It's not stopping ganja. I have used the word of God to pray for this job, but I'm not getting it. Can I help?
You must say it.
Remember, we agreed according to the word of God, according to the scriptures, that this is you, born of the God,
yes,
which is the seed.
Yes, sir.
Imagine the Bible says, I just want to take you back a little bit. Imagine the Bible says, Hebrews chapter 11, verse 20. By faith we believe that the wilds were what? Framed by the word of God. And we believe that the things that are seen were made out of things that are not seen. The word that was able to create everything that you see,
yeah,
including you,
man,
begins now to fail because it's being used by you. So do you think it's the word that has been the problem?
No, sir.
Because if it is not only failing when it is in your hand, it cannot be the word that has been the error.
Amen.
So, and God said, and it was so. And God said, and it was so. And God said, and it was so. And then you say, and it doesn't happen. Then you say, there's a fact, this word is bullshit. Do you know what you are doing by saying, I have prayed and nothing is changing? Do you know what you are saying in act of faith when you say, I have fasted, I have declared, I have confessed, I have used the word, and nothing is changing? Do you know what it means?
No, that's not.
You are actually accusing the word of God of being corruptible. Can I try again? You are actually accusing the word to be corruptible. Because incorruptible means never to be caused to fail by any kind of corruption. Nothing can enter into the word and corrupt it to cause it to change its course. The order of its course is set. It doesn't change. No rust, no witch, no giant. Am I speaking to somebody?
Yes.
So if it begins to fail because it's you using it, please stop a minute. Don't ever believe that lie of the devil that the word you is used is not working.
Amen.
For the word to work, someone must be responsible. And for the word not to work again, someone must be responsible. But the word does not fail.
Amen.
That's why the Bible in the book of Romans chapter number 3 says, so if some by their unbelief never got results, shall we then say the faith of God is without effect? And what was the answer? Nay! Never! Romans chapter 3, verse 3. Never accuse the faith of God. Because if you accuse the faith of God, you are accusing the word of God to be corruptible. And if you accuse the word of God to be corruptible, do you know what you are doing? You are actually accusing God to be a liar. That's a frivolous accusation. That's a dangerous accusation. You need to come to terms with yourself and say, I need help. Someone say, I need help.
I need help.
To understand this thing better.
Understand this
thing. Because there is something you are missing. And I want to help you today.
Amen.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Are you ready for this?
Yes, brother.
Are you sure you're ready for this?
Yes, brother.
Someone say, I'm born of the incorruptible seed.
I'm born of the incorruptible seed.
I cannot fail.
I cannot fail.
As long as this seed is incorruptible.
As long as this seed is incorruptible.
It cannot be conflicted of its God. Never. So I want you to go to Luke chapter number 8, and let's go deeper on this thing. Luke chapter number 8, verse 11. Luke chapter number 8, verse 11.
Now the parable is this. The seed is the word of God.
So this was the parable of the sower, right? And you are now being told in plain words what the parable is. What is the parable?
Those by the wayside are they that hear. Then cometh the devil.
So never think the word you heard is not working.
Amen.
Because they that are by the wayside, devour the man who but is that the way away, does it?
And take it away the word.
So, do you know you can go out of this house thinking you was hearing the word, yet you went out and the word was already taken before you left? And I'll teach you one day how the devil takes the word. He just takes the word by replacing it with another word. You think it's gossip? No! There is something the devil is after. But he wants to make sure you will never come out of this house with it. Because the devil knows the power of the word we preach. Then that devil, knowing now that you don't carry any seed which you must use against me, you then attack.
And take it away the weight out of their hearts, lest they should believe and be saved.
Are you hearing this? The fear of the devil is once you believe the word being preached, you will be saved. And the word, that word saved there is sozo, which covers all the salvation of the Lord, deliverance, healing, prosperity, and everything. So the devil is afraid if you go to church and you go back home with the word. So if there is a battle, believe in the devil, it's not that you must not come to church. Of course, to some levels, he will fight you so that you don't come to hear. But to certain dimensions, he will just fight you so that you don't hear the word. Let's go. Another level.
They on the rock are they which, when they hear, receive the word with joy. And these have no root.
Now, wait a moment. Vasika Peshoko, Zipoko, Territory needs, Rimere needs, Mama. They have no root in the word. Let's go.
Which for a while believe, and in time of temptation fall away, and that which fail among thorns,
now. If surely you have received the word, are you hearing me?
Yes, prophet.
If surely you have received the word, there must be nothing that moves you.
Amen.
Nothing. Amen. Whatever kind of temptation. If you see yourself being moved by any kind of temptation, it's a simple teaching and revelation to yourself that you don't have roots. You don't have the word in you.
Amen.
Are you hearing this?
Yes, prophet.
And
that which fell among thorns are they which, when they hear, go forth and are choked with cares and riches and pleasures of this life, and bring no fruit to perfection.
Watch this. It's also possible that you hear the word and you allow other things to choke the word. I don't know if you're hearing this. But all this is being said as a parable to make people understand the importance and the place of what? The word of God, which is the seed.
Yes, sir.
Now, I want to show you this. I wanted to check that same issue from Mark's perspective, right?
Yes, sir.
Mark chapter number 4, verse 2. There is something that Jesus then said, which is of paramount importance.
And he taught them many things by parables, and said unto them in his doctrine, hearken, behold, they went out and sow to sow.
Now listen. Terera, hearken, tarira. Wakaenda mui, murimi kunodini. Amuspani. Wakaenda mui, kunodini.
And it came to pass, as he saw it, some fell by the wayside.
All right, jump to verse 13. We have heard all that.
And he said unto them, know ye not this parable? And how then will you know all parables?
Now, this is where I want to take my emphasis on the importance of the word of God in spiritual warfare. Just on to Abari, I'm seeing it, no reda, no fada no zuku. Sana mnaja mwese. Let me try again. Jesus is saying, if you do not understand the mystery of seed as the word of God, you don't know nothing about Christianity. Okay. Let me slow down. Are you sure you are here?
Oh, yes, prophet.
If you don't know the place of speaking right, which is speaking the word, as a Christian, you don't know nothing about Christianity. You don't know nothing about the kingdom. If you speak anyhow, if you don't know how to govern your tongue, to make sure only that which comes out of your life and of your mouth is the word of God, you are a joker in the kingdom of God. Because if you don't know the meaning of the seed being sown, to me, the word of God being spoken by a Christian, you don't know nothing. I'm still seeing I'm alone. Can I try again? Can I see that? If you do not know this parable, you don't know any parable, you don't know any key, you don't know any revelation. No! I'm talking about you having your own mouth and speaking words. What you are speaking, you are sowing to whose life? Your life. So whatever you want, speak. You who harvest? You. So if you don't know this people, you don't know anything. So don't then come and say, man of God, I am praying, I am fasting. What do you say after prayer? What do you say after church? What do you say in your house? What do you say with your friends? Is it the word? If it is not, you are sowing. In whatever you are sowing, you are harvesting. So, what you are harvesting is your words, not your prayer points or prayer requests.
Amen.
You don't harvest your 7 days of prayer first. You harvest the seed you have sown. Results. And the Papa wants it and I'm sick again. Who sick as the issue? I'll let you see. Number one, it also goes further to show us that if you don't know what are the core values of the kingdom of God, God cannot entrust you with anything. Let me do this. Let me show you this. They are what are called core values. Go to the book of Luke chapter number 1. Let me deal with core values. I want you to read like you can read.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh.
For as much as many have taken into hand to set forth in order a declaration of those things which are most usually believed among us.
Now, I know you think you are hearing what you are wrong. This is dangerous. What did I say?
This is dangerous.
So as much as many have taken in hand to set for the what? In order. Someone say order.
Order.
That is what is called the course of order in the realm of the spirit.
Amen.
There is the realm of the spirit has got an order.
men.
There is a way the realm is ordered. And if you don't align to the way it's ordered, you're in trouble. So he's now saying, as many as now taken into hand, as many as now understood the course of order of the realm of the spirit. Let's go after order.
A declaration of those things which are most surely believed among us.
Now wait, there are things that must be most surely believed. Do you know what? Other truths are smaller than other truths.
Yeah. Amen.
Okay, wait. There are truths that if you do not master, any other truth that you master will not help you. Wait. There are truths that are foundation. Then there are truths that are like bricks, windows, roofs, everything. Yet truth. But if you take for granted the foundational truth, the core values you are building on self, whatever you do, you then cry, I have fasted. It's a truth, but it's not a core value. You then cry and you say, I have prayed. It's not a foundational truth. When you are praying, when you are fasting, when you are giving, you are actually building upon a foundation. But the truth that are foundations, you don't like. Even after teaching you like this, you speak anyhow. Listen, core values work like this. If you are taught a core value, then you remove it. It's like, according to the order of the realm of the spirit, it's like you have removed the foundation of the house, then you continue building. What happens to that house? No matter how good the window, we're not going to come up second, but you are going to go to the house, you are going to go to the house. But if you don't walk, put out a simple show about your life, you are building on top of the sand.
Amen.
That I don't see that sin in this parable. You don't know anything. Continue reading.
Even as they delivered them unto us, which from the beginning were eyewitnesses and ministers of the word, it seemed good to me also, having had perfect understanding of all things. From the very first, to write unto thee in order.
In what?
In order.
In order. These are not. And
most excellent Theophilus, that thou mightest know the certainty of those things.
What ones? We see, say, who goes, what is in Jesus?
Wherein thou hast been instructed.
So are you seeing? There is a way in which you are instructed as a believer. Core values. Someone said core values.
Core values
is what Christians take for granted.
Is what Christians.
So if you are studying the Bible, you will discover that every construction of a scripture starts with a core value, then it goes to truth that are minor. But if you don't have an eye like I have to show you the course of the realm of the spirit and how it's ordered, and for you to listen to that as a core value and treasure it and value it, and put a chop on it, chino father up to you. Go to the back of but before you, let's talk about the Ibaba. Okay, I'll give you three examples of core values. Number one, we have already seen from the word of God, from the word of Jesus, that how you speak is a what?
It's a core value.
Kana ukazo chaya sanya, we want to destroy him. Apana. Kana ukazo, do you know we have people who say, I have tithed and it's not working. I have sacrificed, it's not working. Those are minor truths. Are you building upon core values? You are building, yes, but the reason why your tithe falls, the reason why your giving falls, the reason why your fasting falls, is because you don't have a foundation. You have believers that do not have a foundation of core values. Now, another covenant, the Bible says, being built upon the foundation of apostles and prophets, Jesus being the chief cornerstone. Do you know what that means? It emphasizes the place of authority. Watch. Ephesians chapter number 1, verse 1 says, honor your father and your mother in the Lord. For this is a commandment with a promise. Right? Then if you jump to chapter verse 12, it says what? We do not wrestle against flesh and blood. Now already I'm done. Are you here? Have you seen what I want to do? So this man can be wrestling against principalities, powers. That's not the main issue then. Of course, wrestling against the flesh is corrected, but we wrestle against. But even if he knows you don't wrestle against flesh and blood, and he begins to wrestle against principalities, powers, dominions, without having put in order the place of spiritual authority according to verse 1, you are fighting without a government. Did you got that? Verse 1 is going to honor. Verse 12 is going to fight. Then you dishonor. And you go to the mountain to fight. Are you not fighting? But why are you losing? You are building on top of a removed foundation. See that? So when I come here and I say, understand the place of authority. I don't know what you hear. But I continue saying it until you hear the correct thing. I am saying, you have battles. You are praying. You are fasting. But you need a foundation. You are built upon. Then you are told you are built upon. And you push away the apostle, the prophet, and you build.
Brothers will not
It up to one factor.
Amen. Amen.
Nelipara mazwa Israel hei na muhundo. David na kutu kumasoja. Dona wena. Do you know what they told me? You are more than how many of us?
10,000.
Do you know what they are saying? We might be 10,000, but we are minor kids. But you is the father. Can I 10,000 of our fathers? You know that, but you didn't move your money.
Amen.
There are things that you play around with simply because you're good. I'm telling you the truth now. There are areas that you touch simply because you are foolish. My soldier and this mysteries. I put it. Did I get come at 10,000? I should not problem. Product the good not to so bad can I mal way of good. Go to put my soldier 10,000. Can I put it? Can I put it? So there are things that are core values. And I will find a day to just teach you a lot of the core values. Because the devil doesn't want you to know core values. He wants you to be Christians who is a full of activity without results. You can be full of activity without any result. Because you don't understand. You must be doing those things. On what? On top of foundational issues. I was just giving you examples of core values, but my issue is how you speak is a core value.
Amen.
Whatever you do after your speech doesn't matter. Hello?
Amen.
Look at this. So, here Jesus is simply saying words are a core dimension of sowing into the spirit. Now, I want you to go to Galatians chapter number 6, verse 7. Galatians 6:7.
Be not deceived.
Be not deceived.
Be not deceived.
Sit up.
God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth.
Share. Now. Remove sowing and put to Revelation. Let's see if you're getting me.
Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man speaketh.
Thank you.
That shall he also reap.
Are you hearing this?
Yes, I am. Okay.
Whatsoever a man
speaketh.
Check your neighbor and say, what are you harvesting?
What are you harvesting?
Saka, put tali sila prosperity. You hold your tower of poverty. Who funga kutu mariva no more? Because masete ya wangeta kota inwea, they would teach our tower of kutu no koa. Saka kufungi tila mucha koa prosperity. You hold your tower of kutu. You hold your tower of kutu. You hold your tower of kutu. Kufungi tila kutu you can mock God. Ele kutore wa kutu. You are no longer yourself. No, I don't. Do you know you can think you're still yourself? Yet you're not deceived. Do you know the state of being deceived?
Romans chapter number 8.
Romans chapter number 8.
There is therefore.
First of all.
Therefore, brethren, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live after the flesh.
Do you know what that means? Come here. Come now. My dear brother, we are no longer what? A teenage query to the young man. Jesus is not put to many songs, what can I have? What's that? Fana Mutaura. Those are the other Mutaura. Would you always hold down? Sana, you are not sick until you agree with your flesh. My God. So, what is sickness? You are not pure on a Saturday, but to who Mutaura is all good. Yaucha so vanayo yekukowa manje kusini. Awuware iwewe from nowhere. Zokurai. Chirwere chokurai ndechawakazodyara ukakowa. After washandisiwa, sick yekubatsiwa nzakadzi. That's what the Bible says. Let the sick say what?
I am healed.
Why? Because I am healed is you now determining your fate.
Amen.
So I'm not chiquerity, but Antina chiquerity.
Antina chiquerity.
Nyama.
Nyama.
It says we are not debtors of the flesh, that we might
to live after the flesh.
You know what that means? Your flesh includes your eyes, right? If you speak what you see, you are living like a god. You own the flesh. Because your flesh is sin, and you want to. Please, what you see. The Bible says, we do not move by. We move by faith, not by. So, if somebody is dying, what does faith say? So, if you say, he's, amen. You know, I'm going to go to China. I'm going to go to China. I'm going to go to China. Watch your person, yes, man. You are pleasing the flesh that you see. But is that the truth that you have seen? What does the truth say? By his stripes, we are healed. So you are liars when you move around and say, ah, if you look down on another. So you can have the Spirit of God in you, And you need to yourself. And the Bible says, as many as are
led
are what?
Are the sons of God.
And the word son then means you, is the dimension of sonship. That word is yours, which is a mature son. And mature son then means, actually means son blessed. The word is son blessed, which means positioned for inheritance. So that you don't get to harvest is what number in this shako. Mature. I'm teaching better than you. Listen. Verse 6. Listen to verse 6.
For to be carnally minded is death.
What is the danger? To be carnally minded is what?
It's death.
Clank. No, you missed it. To be what?
Carnally minded.
Is equal to what?
To death.
It's either you are spiritually minded or you are carnally minded. Because you are no longer naturally minded because you are born again. You can either be carnal or be spiritual. You are no longer natural. But you are either carnal or born. So even though you are born again, you can be born again. Not natural, right? And yet be carnal. And you harvest death. Not because you're not a child of God. Not because God is not love. Not because that's the intentions of God regarding your life. But simply because you're carnal. Amen.
But to be spiritually minded is life and peace.
Hmm.
Because the carnal mind is enmity against God.
Shame on you. Good to remember our mind. But you know what the end of your mind? Matter. Quit your word. Chat. But even your language, even your speech, creates an enmity between you and God. Because how can you say, I am sick? Yet God sent his only begotten Son to die for you and take away your sicknesses. So you could have an enemy in the fact that you are saying your works are in vain. What do you think God will do? You hurt you. And
for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be.
Mm.
So they that are in the flesh cannot please God.
You cannot be fleshly and please God at the same time. Never. Never. Now we're going to talk about Genesis chapter 3, verse 16. Don't go there. It's a way of conclusion. After the fall, this is the declaration of God. The seed of a woman shall bruise the head of the what?
Serpent.
And the seed of the what?
Serpent
shall bruise the what?
The
heel of the seed of the woman. What is the seed? What is the seed? What is the seed there? Where do we? Nebuchadnezzar Genesis is watching. Jesus watching. And this is the parable. What is the parable? The seed is the what? Sir, kuna Genesis is seed. No one went. And Jesus had to do the seed he went. Such a
man.
So I now turn this seed. You can't. You can't handle the rich. So I turn it. Church. Show for the church. Against what? Show for Satan. And never. And Satan and never. You have people here. So you don't fight against the devil. Your words fight against the words of the devil.
Man.
Now, what are the words of the devil? You are poor. You are sick. You will die. And what are your words? I am poor. I am sick. I will die. kubva pano newapiwa tsvimo yekunonesa satani wozova netsvimo yasatani naunozoti shoko rasatani ndorekunzi seed of the devil shoko rako iwe ndorekunzi seed of the woman satani apa ane rake shoko ndo tsvimo yake achiti ari kukurova neshoko rekuti ndini iwapuwa iwobva wamhanya unoti aye wazvina kuwana mumandiro yamandoti anawana wobvuta kutsvimbo iwobva wati aya ndipuwa saka shoko anopinzi vanhu vatati kuti saka unaimina sei hunde nematauriro enyaya
dangerous.
Stand up. Tell them the words.
Words
are a core value. In the subject of soaking into the spirit. Sala always anujvara kunyama. Anukowa kuora. That's the only way you can corrupt the word of God. By sowing to your flesh. But anujvara kunyama anukowa life eternal. Now watch. I want to finish one around that revelation. That is very important to you and to me. Jesu uno shikipa. Vadzidzi vake vakanga vakaora nenzara. Ndobva vabva vadya vasina kudina. Vasina kugeza maoko. Mafarisisi aida kumaintaina kana kuti keep the natural law yekugeza maoko before eating. But Jesu anobva atora advantage yethat scenario. Onodzidzisa. Chinhu chinofanira kuchenjererwa nemukristu anonoti icho chinopinda uwe mudumbu wachidya nemaoko ane tsvimbo hachisi more dangerous than chinopinda munzeve dzako but chisiri mushoko ramwari Jesu wabva ati be very careful how you ye not how you eat da chawaisa mudumbu chasara kuenda kudu kutoire but chawapinza munzeve chiri kuno transform a brain watch bali kama if I tell you this guy is a thief bit by bit as you continue listening you will believe it and this is what happens. Whatever you keep hearing, right? You take it by your ear. It's thrown into your mind. You meditate upon it. Your mind, the best way to define or to explain your mind to you in angel tones we see in you. When I have a picture of the liar, I'm a filmer. What then do you do? Unoenda kustudio. Wonomereza. Obva azobuda acho. But munogeza sezwa macho munenge muchidzi mutaka. That's exactly how your mind functions. What you hear, what you are picture. Zvinopinda mauri. Wonozogeza. Zvinobuda zvaki. I was like, can I help you? Then I put that 3, 4, 5 times with you. It's all the common ideas. It's all the common ideas. I'm saying it's all. You want to get the money? Ah, sure. He's going to say, oh. He's just going to say, yes, sure. Ah, money that I'm saying, get out of here. Get the 5. I just found the soap. I'm going to turn up a bit of a ocean. We count in a ton of soap. It's so dear, you know, the road to it. Mabatani sheti yake anokutaura kuti tsotsi. Stepi yake inokutaura kuti tsotsi. So our problem as Christians is we are entertaining our negativity. We hear negative things until they make sense. And now it's whatever you entertain becomes true.
Amen.
That's the principle of words. Can I repeat again?
Yes, sir.
Whatever you are told many times becomes true. Oh, God, so we are going to come on a little bit of 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 a little b